everybody. This is Buddy Bison signing in with another episode of the Blind Valkyrie Chronicles LP. So I just bought another report called A Taste of Home, and figured we'd go through this before we get to the chapter and battle. I haven't done any skirmishing or anything between this episode and last, so let's get to it.
And done. That takes care of the report. Hmm? Who's there?
Rome!
Hans? Did you come here all by yourself? Boy, you sure are smart.
Ronk, ronk.
Hey, stop tugging, Hans. What's up? Is there something this way?
Ronk.
Okay, I get it. Lead the way. And you can stop biting my boots already.
You went and got Welkin for me? Nice going, Hans. Thanks.
Ronk.
I just got led around base by a pig. Any idea what he wants with me, Alicia?
Oh no, I was the one who wanted to see you. Are you hungry, Welkin?
Hungry? Well, yeah, actually.
Really? Oh, good. I whipped a little something up for you. Come see.
What? Back in the kitchen? Whoa. Wow. I've never seen so much bread in one place. You baked all this yourself, Alicia?
Mm-hmm. It's been a while since I made anything. I was worried I might be getting a bit rusty. But the oven was free, so I helped myself.
Mmm. It smells great. Okay, here goes.
Welkin, you okay?
Delicious!
Really?
Yeah, I've never eaten bread this good. It's really impressive.
Welkin, you look like a chipmunk.
You know how chipmunks and hamsters stuff their little cheeks full of food like that? I finally understand why.
That was cute.
Oh, I'm so full. That was great, huh, Hans?
I can't believe you put it all away. It was a little scary watching you two eat. Still, I'm glad you liked it. It feels good to see people enjoying my bread.
It felt good eating it. Thanks for baking it all.
You're welcome. Oh, Welkin, you have some... There's just a little crumb. There we go.
Hmm? Oh. So, you said you worked at a bakery before the war started?
Yeah. I was a live-in apprentice under the Meister running the shop. Once things settle down, I plan on taking the national exams and opening up my own bakery.
Like how there's a national exam for opening a bakery. And that sounds ridiculous to me. But it's probably true in general. Like, I wouldn't be surprised.
Need to be licensed to run a bakery? That sounds pretty tough.
It's been my dream since I was a little girl. It's what I enjoy doing the most. I love imagining entire families eating the bread I make together. A loving husband, maybe, and cute little kids waiting for their mom to get home. She comes in with a big basket of my bread, and the kids all cheer and embrace her.
Okay.
Oh, and what if my bread brings the husband and wife closer together? She could say, "Oh, honey, you have a crumb in your beard," and then she'd... Listen to me. That's just like what happened here a minute ago, Welkin, but I,
Are you all right, Alicia?
Huh? I'm fine. Anyway, I'll keep baking it if you keep eating it.
It's a deal. And thanks again.
Okay. Now on to this part of the story. And it's amazing that he ate that entire stack of bread. That's insane.
Strange place. Rocks with holes in them. Dug up ground as far as the eye can see.
Not always. They say this used to be a huge ancient city. Now there's nothing but desert left.
We all know what happened. The Darkson calamity happened. They say the Darkhairs used some kind of dark arts to burn the city. Left nothing but ash.
Can't see what kind of magic it used to burn up this much land, though. It's just crazy.
I don't know. Isara said that was a myth with no real historical evidence.
Look, their kind has been digging up Ragnite since forever. So who's to say they don't know some weird, Darkson-y type way to use the stuff as a weapon? I'm just saying.
Anyway, as I was saying, we are in the middle of the Badlands. And what exactly are we doing here?
We've received some intelligence. They're saying the Imperials have set up a base near the Barius ruins. Squad 7 was sent out here to investigate. We need to verify the information.
Imperians here? Some sandbox to come play in. I don't get those Imperians. Who knows what they're thinking?
She's right. Something is definitely up here. I mean, I just can't figure it out, you know? Why would they occupy this place?
Enemy sighted! Tanks at 040. Distance 800.
Hold on.
Yes. There are foot soldiers as well. And they're taking up combat positions.
Well, it looks like we found our bad guys.
Squad 7, combat formation.
Battle of Barius Desert. But gotta do this one first. Jaeger and Gregor. I'm guessing we're back in, back in the meeting room.
I didn't think you could look any gloomier.
Oh, it's you. Leave me be.
No need to be unfriendly, is there? Is there something on your mind, Gregor?
His Grace, Maximilian. Barius holds no strategic worth. Why lead a force there himself?
He took Selvaria with him, so it probably has something to do with the Valkyrer.
His Grace places too much stock in the power of the Valkyrer.
Maybe. But I can understand the fascination easily enough. The power of the Valkyrer is enough to claim all of Europa. Maybe the entire globe.
Even without it, the Empire's military strength is quite capable of taking control of Europa.
The stronger you are, the shorter that road. I say let him be. My homeland's independence is riding on Maximilian's word. I need him to return to the court with enough clout to honor that deal. Relax. We'll hear all about their desert adventures soon enough.
Can I kill Maximilian? Can I murder him? I want to murder him. I want to murder every single one of these Imperian bastards. Okay. So I'm gonna save. Okay. Now time to go into here. Gonna have a fight.
You will now be briefed on the operation.
Cool. Brief me. The enemy is spread out across a wide area of the desert. You'll move in from the south and take them out. Oh god, this is a big map, I'm guessing. Along the way, you'll find standing remains of ruins, which should make for good cover from enemy fire. Your objective is to claim the enemy's base camp. There's a lot of distance cover out there. I'd recommend adding a long-range sniper unit or two. I can do that. When you're ready to advance, though, their limited AP can mean they might fall behind. In such case, move them to the nearest camp after cleaning the area of enemies and have them retreat. Then, after you advance units occupy the next enemy camp, you can redeploy them there. That'll speed them up. Okay. Yeah. Swapping and leapfrogging units for your camp should be a big help out there. You'd do well to remember it. Okay, Welkin dies. Enemy occupies guy's base camp. Okay. Position units. So, I'm not sure. Like, see, this is the annoying thing, because, like, you don't see what enemy units they have. I'm gonna... going with that many. Of course, I'm gonna go in with Carl. Hell, I'm just gonna go. I'm gonna have this one be my insane amounts of these guys. And I would want to take him because he gives me another move, but it's really just not worth it. Put Rosie there. Isn't that supposed to be like a sniper outcropping? I don't know. Actually, what I'll do is instead of Rosie. Put Cesare there. And then over here, I'll put Rosie. That way, someone comes up, there's at least DPS blocking him. Blocking her. What the hell? Where? Oh, because I moved him. See, like, the one thing I don't like is that you can't see the map very specific.
Squad 7, move out!
And it annoys me. Because, like, at least in Fire Emblem, I'm sure there might be Fog of War sometimes, but at least you can see all the characters. And I understand in this game, like, you don't being able to see everyone.
This place is really something else. I've never seen rocks with holes like these.
Valia was saying those holes are the result of the same blast that scorched the area. There are furrows dug into the ground, too. Must have really been some explosion.
Are you serious? That's crazy.
Yeah, but those trenches and rock walls should make for solid cover.
On an open field like this, we'll use whatever we can get. Squad 7, move out!
Okay, so this is the introduction of trenches, I'm guessing.
Okay. Here we go!
I'm gonna move up with tank. Take out that scout and that shock trooper. I don't think I'm going to be able to hit him, but he's not behind cover. You can 7 shots. Let's try it. Okay, go. Took out the scout. That's a positive. Okay. I'm gonna move in with him just to get him up to the tank. This is a sniper outcropping.
Brace for their attack.
Damn it. Okay, so she's completely useless up here. Perfect. The snipers, I want the circle to be so much smaller than it currently is. Okay. Wait, did I not? Oh my god, I didn't put Alicia out. I'm dumb. I am so dumb.
Hey ladies, nice spot, huh?
Fuck, what the shit was that? Oh, it was a mine. A mine was right there.
Keep an eye on the uneven ground as you walk.
Okay. So that Lancer's right there.
Just, leave it to me.
That mine is taken out.
There's a ton of them.
You're clear to advance.
Here I go. Yippee!
Enemy unit neutralized.
Put her behind that.
Sustained.
That's fine. Oh, fuck you being able to hit from there and I can't do shit. She's probably gonna be taken out by that sniper. Yep, great. Fucking bitch. Really, you can't shoot from their tank?
Minor damage sustained.
Some of these things, like, it's just like, I understand, I probably missed because I was aiming for the head specifically, but still annoying. Okay. She needs to go get.
Found this one.
Yeah. Oh, there's a back path.
Medic.
Wish she didn't cutscene every time, so I had to fucking try and skip it. I'm gonna end her there. Okay, so I'm gonna try and do.
Order's an order. I just want to see the beauty out here.
I took out that Lancer.
See what you get?
Who are these guys?
If you see an opening, strike it.
I need to heal up the tank, because if I don't, could die. Could lose because my tank gets destroyed.
Thank you.
Okay. Just gonna leave him there.
I'm on it.
Gonna move him up. Able to throw at least a little bit further. Wrong. There you go, bud.
So long.
There you go.
Good work. Keep it up.
Okay. God, this battle is. So the battle is mostly just here. And taking this point.
Watch me dance.
Okay.
Enemy sighted.
Pay attention to the enemy's position.
Take out that Lancer.
Gotta love nature.
Try to keep your. Take him out.
There's
a ton of them.
Yes.
damage minimal. Damage minimal.
Yeah, they're only doing 300. God damn it. My guys would not be able to make that shot. And the enemy tanks would be destroying these guys. God.
Underminer fire.
My people wouldn't even get to move. They'd be dead. First, I need to heal the tank.
I'll do my best.
Oh, fuck you.
Thank you.
Okay. I'm gonna end turn there. I'm gonna get rid of that guy. They're coming up behind him. Her. Over.
Strike when you see an opening. Just hold out a little longer.
Sneaky snakes. Yeah, I'm just gonna take that guy out. Make it good.
Next partner.
Man down. Everybody be careful.
Headshot that shock trooper. Okay.
We can all do this. Stay strong.
Okay. Go over. God damn it.
Try to keep your footing in that sand.
Oh, motherfucker.
Everyone's a critic.
Great. Son of a bitch.
You say so.
Turn out of the way.
See what you get?
Man down.
I'm gonna try and go claim the
time for a quick step.
Their base. Okay, claimed it so they're enemy reinforcements aren't able to
take them out.
Do it.
One minute at a time.
Really? Okay, I'm just gonna take that sniper out because might as well take one of them out if possible. This guy,
Understood.
I'll just use him.
Medic!
Yeah. Come on. Run up.
Please hit!
Are you serious? God, that was asininely stupid. My gun was in him. My hit should have been 100%. Okay. Fucking bitch. Check back. I'll be back soon.
Thank you.
Underminer fire! Underminer fire!
Understood.
Okay, so we're back. They introduced sandstorms. I took out a couple of the tanks and whatnot. Well, I took out one of the tanks. I put Alicia over there so they would turn around, which is perfect. So basically what sandstorm does is it makes it so everyone has decreased accuracy. And that's it. So right now I'm just trying to take out this other tank, because tanks are the worst thing possible for me. And what I want to do is I want to make sure I really let it can't miss. Like, getting too close is actually... Fucking I hate these controls. Not all the time, but a lot of the time. Good. Just took out that tank. And what I want to do is I want to... Yeah, apparently I can't enter this very tiny amount of trench. Because I wanted this guy to be looking this way. So she can come in with a grenade. Approach, grenade, and I did find out you can hit yourself with a grenade, so, learning experiences, right? Grenades are useful because I don't believe that their damage drops to those behind cover, so, by doing this, it's actually very positive. Okay, so now, with that, I believe there's one more tank right there. But I want to get Alicia up and around. Oh, hello. I'm going to move back a little. Okay. Gonna move the tank again. God.
Must be my lucky day.
God damn it, that was actually terrible, because I wanted to get him in front of the sniper, in front of the snipers, that way... I don't think I'm going to be able to hit it from this angle. I gotta try. Yes! Good. Okay. So, now I don't have to worry about anything damaging the tank. Because I don't think you can call in a reinforcement of tank. Oh, they got three snipers. And I would have used my two snipers that I have on a building, but they have... God, that's so much damage. But, the thing is, they have... Why is he so strong? Does he just have really good guns? I need to get Alicia a better rifle or something. Yeah, okay. Well, I was expecting it. Alicia's kind of my, like... Oh, because I know I can't really lose you, I'm just gonna throw you out there. But I can lose her. And I don't really want to, because she's pretty good in the desert. So... I'll probably be gonna having... What's-his-face... get into the trench. Okay. So, let's have you... roll up in here. Okay. So now what I want to do... I kind of want to get rid of the snipers as well. But the thing is, they don't, I'm more worried about you. That's fine. That's a sniper. Those guys are snipers.
Understood.
Gonna have him run up. Because I don't think snipers can do like returning fire. Which is useful.
Please stay strong. Yeah. I'm on my way.
So what I wanna do. So I'm gonna come over here with a grenade. Okay, good. Got them both.
Man down. Everybody be careful.
Okay. I want to kill that sniper because extra XP. So I'm gonna leave him there. I want to see if I can get lucky with a sniper shot. Because one of them has sniper killer. Like that. Let's take him out real quick.
Enemy unit neutralized.
So now, end that action. Go get Alicia. Because I can't leave my homegirl on the ground. It was actually pretty funny because as I was doing this, I forgot, like, at a point I forgot that, oh yeah, I'm recording this. So, I then remembered, like, oh yeah. Yeah, I'm further than I was when I died the first time, huh? But most of the things I did in this one were about the same as last time. Oh my god, I got so much more. So apparently, like, the ranks is more only directed, dependent upon how many turns it takes to do something. So the way I have to imagine... getting, like, A rank on these works, Okay, so I got a better sniper rifle. So I'm going to be putting that on probably Cesare. Not sure. I'm actually going to save, and we can go do that. But that was one of the things, like, to get A rank, I have to imagine you just have only scouts, and they all just are, like, max level. You go through, and you're just wrecking everybody. Squad barracks. Okay, so, first I want to check, do I have anything better for Alicia? Nothing better for Alicia. Okay, so do I have anything better for you? So ZMMP, like the range is a lot shorter, but it's a lot stronger. General. So I'm gonna put it on her, because if I am going to use the person, chances are, they're not, like, these guys aren't gonna be at a range. These guys are gonna be up close and personal. But then I also have to do Cesare, because he has Sniper Killer. So Sniper... Oh. Okay. So aim is less, range is a lot less, but the damage it does to people is a lot more. Which would explain why he was doing... Okay. I'm not going to equip it on him, simply because... God, I don't need this many tank killer guys. I'm gonna access Quad 7. Let's go to the command room and switch out some people, because having that many, sometimes they're new ones. You can tell when they just kind of use the same face. None of these guys are really good. Okay, so I don't need... You're fine. You're decent. I don't need four of these people. What? City Kid. Allies. Okay.
That was good.
Yeah. Okay, I can keep three, at least. But I'd like to get... Maybe another sniper? No. But there aren't any more. So... I'll get another... Yeah, I'll get another engineer. Because... Dallas isn't that good of one, because she doesn't like men. But, this is tough stuff. This is tough stuff. Because I already have a shit ton of scouts. You know what? I'm doing it.
Hello, I'm Claudia Mann. I'll do my best to live up to your expectations.
I think I had her the original time. Like, the first time I was doing this. But, unfortunately, you know, the game... crashed or closed on me for something. I don't know why. Okay, so now I have a lot of XP to use. Okay. I'll level up the shock troopers once. Because they're a good class. And just leveling up is just a net positive. Like, leveling up any class is positive. But I do want to get scouts to level 11 really fast. Because as it is right now, they're almost worthless to me in terms of grenades. Ah, okay, that's good. Boost it in general. But it's like, it's an accuracy boost. Well, I mean, I'm gonna take it anyway. Don't know about that one. Okay, yeah. Having those do better, that's good. And less damage, that's good. See, I prefer upgrading just general stats. I'm gonna regret this once I go to the tank or something, because those things usually cost a lot more. Because I want defensive upgrades. Sight upgrade, that's not bad. Just make one more of those. Yeah, I'll take a sight upgrade. This reminds me of the upgrade system from the Mega Man Battle Network games on the Game Boy Advance, where you would have like certain aspects, but they were all like Jenga pieces, so you had to fit them all together. At least I think that was the game. I believe it was. Okay. So let's go back into book mode. And I'm probably gonna do some skirmishing after this battle. Sorry if you hear some noise from outside. Just rather unfortunate. Okay, so let's save. And because I don't know really how much time has kind of passed in terms of the episode, because I did cut out a decent chunk, because unlike Disgaea, you can't rush through this game. Because you have to watch the enemy take the turn, you have to do your turn while also being careful so you don't just, like, dumbly die. But you can't take it for granted, really.
Huh? What's this supposed to be anyway?
What a weird place for something like this.
There you all are.
Hey there, Faldio. I didn't know you were out here too.
I'm an archaeology major, remember? I was ordered to observe the ruins' interior.
The shape of it really is unusual. I've never seen anything like it.
I feel like I've seen it before somewhere. Where could it have been?
This building was supposedly erected millennia ago by the Valkyr themselves.
So they actually existed then?
Yes. The Valkyr make a sudden appearance in European history, thousands of years ago. Records say they brought with them incredibly advanced technology and divine might. Then one day, their history just ends. The Valkyr just disappeared.
I always thought they were just a myth.
That's it. I remember now.
Remember what, Welkin? What are you shouting about?
The Dread Nautilus. This structure looks just like a Dread Nautilus.
A Dread Nautilus? What's that?
You don't know? They're marine cephalopods. They live inside pointy spiral shells. And these ruins look just like that shell. I wonder if there's some connection there.
Welkin, you can be such a...
What's up?
Nothing. Forget it.
Right. Let's take a look inside then. We may find some clue to why the Empire is out here.
Alicia, I want you to come help Faldio and me look around inside. Largo, Rosie, and Isara, you stay here. Be on the lookout for movement in the area.
All right, sir. Please be careful.
Okay, time to get to the next episode. I moved the mic, trying to get a little bit away from the window so it wouldn't pick up outside noise, but I think it's still going to anyway. So I'm just moving it here again.
Tell me, Silvaria, do these walls offer an answer to our search?
I pray, where sleeps the ancient power?
What do you read, child?
The Holy Lance, scorcher of the vast earth, asleep eternal in the bosom of Ranrass, made pillar of its keeper's keep, kept thereby for eon without end.
Then it's true. The sacred lance lies buried within Rongreese's walls.
But your grace, how do you intend to control the lance once it is found?
Worry not. A beast fit to bear that burden will soon be at our disposal. With this, our dream is made hard fact. Our crown shadow will extend to all of Europa.
Okay, so they're just bringing in...
Chapter 7, The Battle at Barius.
Okay, so right, we're at the Barius Ruins, but this is probably going to be more like the city itself. Okay. So, I'm going to save here, and I'm going to end the episode here as well, because I'm not sure how long it's been going, but I've been playing for 120 minutes. No, almost an hour and a half. That's almost 2 hours, 120 minutes. So, this is the end of episode 7, I believe. So I hope you all have a very nice day.